Hey, welcome back to the Raccoon Fact Show. We're going to be changing it up today. Instead of doing a very vague tutorial on how to do something nobody would want to do, we're going to have a more in-depth tutorial on something that I think every Discord person should want to know how to do. Today, we're going to be going over how to make it where you can play Pokemon games or other Game Boy Advance or Game Boy Color or whatever simple controlled games you want through commands on your Discord like this. Right out the gate, if you don't actually want to build this, but you just want to participate, right here and down below in my description, I should have my Discord link. Go ahead and join my Discord. I try to do this every Monday. If you have any problems with this tutorial, feel free to comment the question down below, and maybe I'll see it. I do try to answer my comments a lot, but it may behoove you to go ahead and join my Discord if you have a problem and ask there. I never sleep, so I almost always see people's Discord messages. The overall difficulty for this project should be around a 2 out of 5. I made the code maybe a little bit more simpler than I should in some places, so it's not going to be as nuanced or as optimal as some people with engineering degrees would probably like. But for the average just Discord user being able to use this, it should be pretty simple. The first thing you're going to need is your ex's laptop. You know, the one that you kept, but you don't have emotional attachment to. It's just she left it and you feel weird about throwing out a perfectly good laptop and you're a low-key hoarder. What if you needed it for something someday? That one. The reason I recommend using a laptop instead of your main computer is just because we're going to be using Input Simulator and it's going to take over your device. So you're not going to be able to use your computer while you're streaming to your Discord. Before we start, I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a pro tip when watching tutorials. If for whatever reason the person is going too fast, you can slow it down through the playback speed here. Or if they're going too slow, you can speed it up using the playback speed as well here. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go over to the Discord developer portal. And the link should be in my description. Go over here to application. And then just log in with your Discord information. Once you're logged in, you're gonna wanna go to new application and name it something like Pokebot. And generally, I like to go ahead and just put a random picture just so I know what it is when it hits my Discord, and then a description, this is Pokebot. Save changes. Then you're gonna wanna head over to the left and hit bot and go to add bot. Don't even read that, just hit yes, do it. Perfect. And you want to give it administrative privileges. Go over to OAuth, and we need to make it so you click bot right here, and administration again. And you're going to want to take this link, copy it, and then just paste it into your browser. Select the server you want to put them in, and continue. And authorize. Perfect. Go back and check your Discord server and make sure that the bot made it. I like to make all my bots have the bot privileges and roles and stuff, but you can do whatever you want. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is download the Visual Studio Community Edition version. The link should be in the description down below. And yes, I can already hear some of you guys. I am coding this in C#. I know that you could maybe use a Raspberry Pi instead of a laptop and code all of this in Python. But I'm a free man, and I can code in whatever language I want to. Normalize not using Raspberry Pis on every single DIY project. Now, you don't need all of the workloads or individual components. The ones with the blue check marks are the ones that I have installed right now. I would be willing to guess that the only ones you need is the .NET and the Universal Windows Platform Development. Once you downloaded Visual Studio, go ahead and open it and come over here to clone a repo. And then when it says repo location, you're going to head over to my GitHub. I'll have the link in the description, and you're going to click code, and then you're going to copy this link. Both links will be in the description. Head back to Visual Studio and just input it there. Now, the reason I'm getting an error here is because I already have this path because it's already on my computer. So I'm just going to put like a V2 just so I know that this is the one I'm downloading from my GitHub. Once it opens up, you're going to want to head over to your Solution Explorer and you're going to want to head to the Pokemon Discord app and then double click the program and it should pop up the actual C# program. All right, so now that you're in the program, the first thing that you need to change is the token. Now, a lot of people like to put this into a text document. You can totally do that. I have it written right here if you want to put it into a text document, but I figured it would be easier for everyone if we just had it in plain text with the quotes in the coding. Head over back to the Discord developer portal, go over to bot, and then where it says token, just copy the token and then paste it right in there. Now, I'm not going to hide it. I want to make sure you guys know what it looks like. But I am deleting this bot later, so I'm not really worried about anybody taking it or hacking me or whatever they would do with it. All right, now that you have your token inputted, we're going to go ahead and come over here and download the emulator we're going to use. For this video, I'm just using the Visual Boy Advance, but feel free to change it up. You can use different game consoles, different emulators, whatever you want, as long as the controls are simple. Now, when it comes to the game, there's a few options. And one option that I just won't stand for is piracy. You see, I stand with Nintendo on pirating 15-year-old games. In fact, right down here at the bottom, right here, that's putting an empty milk cartridge back into the refrigerator. Mass murder. All the way up here, you can't even see it, it's so high up. Pirating 15-year-old games. So what I'm saying is you should not type in Game Boy Advance ROMs Pokemon into Google. Click on one of the first links you find, pick a game that you like, and then download it, because that would be illegal, and I do not stand for it. Not at all. Do not do it. Now that you have everything downloaded, you're going to open up your Visual Boy Advanced, head over to Options, Joypad, Configure, and we'll go ahead and just configure one. And you're going to want to change all of your buttons to match mine here. The reason is because this is how I coded it. Now, if you wanted to change the buttons here to something else, you totally can, but then you would have to change it in the code as well. And it's actually pretty simple. You would just come over here to Virtual Key Code, so this one is to go right. And you would just change the V_D to whatever you wanted. So say you wanted to make it virtual key and you underscore and you wanted to make it, I don't know, V. You would just change it to V just like that. And you would do the same thing over here. You would just change it to V. But we're not going to do that, at least for my video. You can change it if you want. It's completely up to you. But I would just leave all the keys to being this. Now, just to smooth out some details, in the actual package that you downloaded, we have the Pokemon PNG, which is actually the control page. So when you want to know the controls, all you have to do is type in !controls, and it'll pop up with this picture. The picture itself is kind of dated, so please change it. For the love of God, do not have people trying to ping me. And also, go ahead and delete the try open port. I used to have this done in a different method, but I thought it was too convoluted and stupid, so I ended up changing it. Now, I also only have it where you can only move 9 places. You can go up 1, up 2, up 3, up 4, up 5. So say you wanted to go up 1 place, you could just do !up, and then it should just do 1W. You could do !up 5, it should do 5Ws. And then, of course, !9, it should do 9Ws. And then !up 10 should just do 1. The reason why is because if you go too much. So like say you allow them to go up 99. Everybody's just going to be waiting while the player is just running into the wall. And that's not as much fun. So I found like the perfect little balance is just to go 10 places or 9 places. But it is your Discord after all. So if you want to have insane numbers, you totally can. So if you want to do 50, 99, whatever you want, you can just put it right here and it should change it. Now that's just for the up command. If you wanted to change it for each one, you would come down to the down command, change it here again, and then again here, and again down here. Another problem or change that people might want to do is how long you hold the key down. So depending on your game, you might have to hold it down longer, or maybe the next time before you can press it again, you have to hold it down a little bit more. I'm using Thread Sleep, which I know isn't the most nuanced way to do this. It's a little, you know, most people would frown upon doing it this way. But I have found that Thread Sleep is simple and it works really well for this particular project, simply because you don't want a bunch of commands going at the same time, like if you did like a timer. Instead, you just want this one command to go. Then once it's finished, another command will go. And I like that aspect of it. So that's why I did it this way. But also just for you guys, I felt like it would be a lot simpler. So this is in a milliseconds. So if you wanted to change this to like 500 because you wanted the key to be pressed longer, you totally can. It's just going to depend up to you. Oh, and before I forget, you can also do a key press. So that would look like simulator.keyboard.keypress right here. And then you would just be exactly the same. So like virtual key code and then just dot whatever key you wanted. And what that would do would be it would just press the button like if you were just to tap like the V button. So like that. That's what that would be. But sometimes for a lot of these games, I notice it doesn't work because it needs that key down just held a little bit longer. So that's why I always use the key down and key up commands. And of course, there's a lot more commands that you can do, like simulator.mouse, and then you have all these options. You can move the middle mouse, left click, left double click. You can even move its positioning, its scroll, I think. Mouse move position on virtual desktop. So you can move its position, stuff like that, if you're deciding that you want to use a mouse. All right, before we finish up here, go ahead and check to make sure the program works. So press the play button or debugging button, whatever you want to call it. It's going to say Discord, connecting, connected, ready. And that means it should be working. Go ahead and exit out of it. Head over to build. And I like to do batch build and then just click this for the release. And build it. It'll take 1 second. Go ahead and go down here where you see the file location and just copy all the way to release. Head over to your file explorer and just paste it in here. Go ahead and click on .NET 5. I'm an idiot. And then here's your program right here. So you should be able to just open it up. Boom. And it should be working. One thing I like to do is just create a shortcut. And then I put that shortcut on my desktop. And then I have it right here for whenever I need it. Now for the final bit for how you get it to actually work in Discord is you're going to want to start up the program. Then you're going to want to head over to wherever your like video chat would be, your voice channels. For mine, I just have this one under developing. And then you're going to want to stream the Visual Boy Advance. And generally, you can put it on the lowest frame rates because the frames for this are pretty low already. You don't want to waste the bandwidth if you can help it. And then just go live. And it should be there. So you want to make sure that this is in focus and that this is what you've clicked on last. And now it should work. I'm just going to show you from my laptop and show you what this looks like. All right, so I now have it streaming on an alt account on my laptop. I do recommend getting an alt account just so you can play with your streamers because you really can't play it and stream it at the same time because you have to let the computer control your mouse and keyboard. So I recommend doing that on the laptop. Then just come over here and just type in something like up 9, and it should move you up 9. We'll go left 2. Remember with certain games, if you look left, that's one left key press, and then so up 9. And then you go up 9. Simple as that.
Well, thank you so much for making it to the end of the video. I really appreciate you. If you did make it to the end, don't forget to like and comment and all that stuff. It really does help me out. And honestly, I do read through all the comments. I read all of them. So feel free to just leave a comment down there. If you have any problems, like I said, leave a comment or preferably go on my Discord and ask there that I'll be able to help you out. I'm going to have a little section soon dedicated just to helping people out on stuff that I build, or if you have any other technical problems. I am going to be trying to start school again, go back and get my degree. I'm hoping that that will make it where I code cooler and funner stuff for you guys, but it could also have the opposite effect where I'm so busy doing other things that I can't code and do stuff like that. So just be patient with me. I know some people are getting a little angry at me, so I do apologize, and I'm going to keep trying to put up content as fast as I can, but I do appreciate your patience. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great one.